As you approach town, there is no sign of activity. Buildings stand in ruin. Vehicles are overturned, blackened with fire. Explosion marks radiate outward from walls and pavement. In the distance, strange-looking creatures circle in the sky like monstrous leathery vultures. Monstrous leathery vultures. The world has drastically changed from what you knew. Meh, not very much. Some sort of cataclysm has befallen Earth. You think? Returning mankind to the Dark Ages. Maybe not the Dark Ages. Maybe post-apocalyptic world. Like it is. And along with it, your hopes of finding a warm meal and some answers, you decide to look around and scavenge what you can find from the ruins. Okay, sorry if you could hear that bubbling. It was me taking a drink. All right, so we're going to scavenge. That's going to, I guess, no, it doesn't take a point. So I'm at 3-4 right now. So these are different things in the area. You can go into any of these places and hopefully not find someone. So let's try the abandoned house first. We'll go confirm. Suburbs were hit hard in the collapse, with masses of people fleeing urban centers in search of supplies and supernatural threats encroaching from the wild. Supernatural threats. Weird. The suburbs became the front lines of the war for survival. Still, houses like these are so numerous that some have been entirely missed by scavengers, and they tend to be less likely to fall over than the bigger buildings in the urban centers. So that was just a short description. This gives me sort of like a basis of like what I can find in this area. So I assume that this is how sneaky I can be. I don't know if it's some sort of modifier. It must be like how easily I can be found. And then safety is like how safety versus the environment that you're in, like searching this will give you. And then this is like the potential for loot. So we'll hit confirm. And I found some stuff and all those items just went into my thing. So we will go to the inventory. Awesome. Oh man, this is so much different. Oh, yeah, you'll find these scraps of papers that also have recipes on them and whatnot, so. Meat from a large corpse. One large corpse. Oh, a CD. Oh, UVD. Excuse me. UVD. Oh, plastic bag. Okay, so we can use this as a backpack now, which is awesome. And it gives us a little bit of room, so we can take this out of our hand now and be a little bit less encumbered. This is awesome. I have never found pants in the first house that I went into. Maybe I would have in the 11th game. But, yeah, so let's put these... Oh, it's a shoe? Oh, man, it's a shoe. Alright, so I guess I put it on the wrong foot. And this little uncomfortable thing came out. That's good. That's good. Alright, let's hope I can find another shoe in another place. We'll put pants on. Hopefully they're not soiled. Yep, doesn't look like it. But they are in 39 condition. So they're probably like fashionably holy. We'll put this CD in there. Probably don't need any more shards. Let's try using. So I'm going to use this and see what happens. And it didn't do anything. Am I doing the right thing? Is it use? Yes. That is use. Okay, well, I'll keep it. I kind of don't understand that. Maybe it went into the crafting thing. Let's find out. Okay, so we'll go crafting. Known recipes. What was it called? Large corpse. Oh, what? Tarp shelter. That's stupid. Man, I should have really looked at this stuff. whatever. Stupid. Okay, so I apparently didn't get this new thing. Let's no. Okay, it's in my pack. So we'll go back to this jabby. We'll switch this back to move and see what happens. Nothing? Nothing. I guess we just keep this and then eventually figure it out. I have no idea. Again, this was not covered in the tutorial on the demo, and I didn't see like a demo jobby in the main menu, so I could have totally missed it though. Because I just wanted to get this done. All right, so enough of that. We'll just figure it out later. Okay, there's more stuff scavenge, and we have used the move, so we are now at 2. So let's do some more scavenging. Why not? All right, let's do the storage shed. Confirm. Mixed bags. Ostensibly, there should be some goods inside, but then again, anyone here before you going to clean it out. Still, it's worth a shot. All right, let's do it. Apparently, I have found the jackpot. Oh, what? Man. All right, so moral of the story is if you have the freaking demo, get the real game. Okay, so I love the plastic bags because you use them as backpacks, and you can also you can use them as backpacks, which is great. Great idea. And they also, when you're not using them, they crumple up into small balls. They don't have a lot, but, you know, they're useful in that. See, like, the backpack obviously has a little bit more room in it. So we will start throwing, nope, I don't want that in my, this is another thing I don't like. It just sort of throws crap wherever it wants. I gotta move back to the move dialogue and drop it. Cool. More meat corpses. Or is that the same thing I had before? Oh, God. Whatever. All right. So more shard. Nah, whatever. We don't need more shards. We can put it in this thing, though. Okay. Dropped it in there. Now we get a meat cleaver. That's awesome. Did I just select the... Okay. Yeah. All right. So that's a good weapon. I like that. This can be in a backpack. I have not used traps yet, so we'll see what happens with that. We got some potato chips. A potato.
Potato.
Oh, here we go. See? Noise traps strung around the area help to alert the player to creatures while they sleep. So that's useful for your camp stuff. So I guess we'll use that, and you can put that in here and make your life a lot better. I can go into one of these buildings and sleep here, so my shelter is up and my sleep is up, even though I don't have, you know, anything else. Or I can go into the woods. I don't have to sleep in this thing. So see, if I select that, then this pops up. And it changes the shelter and whatnot. Just depends on what's here. So see our weapon changed because we got a meat cleaver in it now. Sorry, wrong thing. Okay. Yay. Good scavenging. And the camp thing is up because I clicked on the camp thing. I switched back and forth. We're not gonna set up camp now. All right, so we got one more move left, so let's scavenge one more place. Let's try to find trouble. Supernatural hordes from the wild. See, that doesn't bode well with me. That's not how Detroit is. I mean, I assume. I don't know. People from Detroit, chime in. Okay, so we got broken bottles. Oh, cargo pants. And they're in better condition. Cool. Alright, so we'll just leave our... Actually, let's scrap those. Take the cargo pants. Wear those. Finally, some boots. A left foot boot. So... Oh, wow. That sucks. All right. So we will take that and maybe scrap this 9% thing. That's kind of stupid. And we have some water. So
I assume we can take away. I don't know. I guess we can't.
Because a water bottle or water takes up 6 spaces. So, one of these empty things can't be filled with water. I believe. I don't know. Let's find out. Nope, can't. And we also can't put it anywhere in our person because you can't just, like, carry around water in your hand, obviously. Be cool if you could. Want to put the water in the shoe? Have a shoe glass. I know, I'm hilarious. All right, rifle scope. That's kind of cool. I wonder if I can attach it to my meat cleaver. Oh, no. That would just switch it. Let's find out. Oh, damn it. Man, I wanted to, like, no scope, or, I mean, quick scope some guys with meat cleavers. Guess that's not going to happen, games. Thanks, Obama. All right, let's go to the crafting menu since we got it up. And yellow thing, I guess, says that we have it equipped. Or, yeah, we have it equipped. All right, so let's start breaking down some shit. Let's throw this in here, and I can get some string and some dirty rags. How do I do this? Oh, I don't have enough moves to craft. So, that is why. Man, still can't craft from that crap. So, I think we could use this. We could, like, drink this or something. Let's try the shoe. Let's see if we can... Really? You can't craft anything from shoes? That's kind of garbage. Dumb. How about a chew and some shards of glass? Or where's my meat cleaver? Nope. Dumb. All right, I guess we shall set up shop for the night in this place. So we'll go to camp. No, I'm sorry. We'll just go through our turn. So we're still... So this thing says that there's stuff on the ground at the site, so other people could come in here, and if they check wherever I am, I guess, they can pick it up. But hopefully that won't happen. And see, it remains on the ground, even when we change turns, I believe. So let's end our turn, because it's the only thing we can do.